Good afternoon. If you could please take your seats, we'll get started. Again, good afternoon, everybody. And before we get started, I'd like to welcome to the stage Dana Fritz Hansen, director of the Grand Rapids Art Museum, to come up and say a few words. After all, we are in his house today.
Well, thank you very much, and it's so exciting to see all of you here today. Thanks for coming out on a not such a wonderful weather day, but we know that April showers bring May flowers and better weather, and so it's great to have you here at the Grand Rapids Art Museum. This is something, there's a project that I've participated in ever since I got here about 3 years ago, and I'm thrilled to have it happening here again. The Art Museum recently did some thinking about who we are, what we want to do. We came up with a purpose statement, and that says that we want the Grand Rapids Art Museum to be a cultural beacon and a civic anchor. So think about that for a second. A cultural beacon, like a beacon is like a lighthouse. We want to shine a light on culture, on art, on ideas. But we also want to be a civic anchor. We want to provide a base for the community, for good things happening in the community. And I can think of nothing better than this nicotine tobacco crushing project that the museum can be a part of, because it involves artistic excellence, it involves communication, but it also involves us coming together to address a problem, address something which we should all be aware about. And what's great is the youth of our community are speaking up. You're going to see some spectacular posters and commentary and these getting these ideas out so that we can change the future. We can literally save lives with your art and your communication. So thank you very much. We're thrilled to have you here, and on with the show.
Okay, before I get started, since we are a social media being, everybody wave, say hello. This is for my, yay, you know, Facebook and Twitter. All right, I got that done. Thank you. So good afternoon, everybody. And again, we're delighted that you've all been able to join us. Can you believe it? We're celebrating our 9th annual nicotine poster contest. So it's been 9 years in the making. That's great. The Nicotine Project began in 1996 with a group of volunteer physicians going to fifth grade classrooms in the Grand Rapids Public Schools and talking with the students about the dangers of tobacco. It then expanded to include the additional elementary age interventions of tobacco, no way, and fifth grade lung day, as well as an integrated full middle school curriculum and teens against tobacco use, a youth leadership program for high school students, as well as this annual contest poster. Before we get started, though, we would like to take a moment to recognize our sponsors for this year's 2015 contest and this evening's ceremony, the Richard and Helen DeVos Foundation and the Kent Medical Foundation. We are sincerely grateful for their continuous support. In addition, again, Dana, thank you so much, the director here at the Grand Rapids Art Museum, who has donated the use of this beautiful auditorium and both the juried poster contest and the award ceremony this evening. And Rick Wynn, president of the Amway Grand Plaza Hotel, who has generously provided delicious reception that you will all get to enjoy immediately following tonight's ceremony. You can't have a party without food, right? Our prizes for this year's contest were donated by the Richard and Helen DeVos Foundation, Steelcase Inc., Meyer Corporation, Kendall College of Art and Design, Frederick Meyer Gardens and Sculpture Park, and the Grand Rapids Public Museum. RDV Corporation provided the personnel needed to organize and coordinate these events. Following the ceremony, you'll have an opportunity to view each of the posters entered this year. These are displayed on tables as you exit the auditorium to your left if you are facing the podium, so right out there. We do ask all of you who competed this year to please leave your posters behind here at the museum following the ceremony. These will be returned to your schools within the next few days. T-shirts with the winning poster printed on them can be obtained after the award ceremony from your school administrators. All right. And now, you know, at every and all of our ceremonies over the past 8 years, we have enjoyed the enthusiastic endorsement of Mayor George Hartwell of the City of Grand Rapids, who is currently serving his second and sadly final term in office. And he's very conscious of this devastating effects of tobacco to the health of our citizens. The devastating effects of lots of things, right, Mayor? He is present with us here today because of his conviction that the best way to stop the ravages of tobacco use is to prevent the use by society's most vulnerable members. Many of us here today have already made or will be making the decision about whether or not we will try a tobacco product. The mayor would like to talk to us now about the importance of these kinds of choices. Please welcome Mayor of Grand Rapids, the Honorable George Hartwell.
Thank you, Ava. Isn't Ava Gary Cooper an awesome MC? And Dana Friis Hansen, he's given us a new visual for this. It's a tobacco crushing event. Dana, thank you for that. That's great. Well, look at you. This is wonderful. I do look forward to this event every single year, and I'm so glad that we're having it again. Even if this is my last time as mayor, I wanted to be here and congratulate all of you because you're all winners. And you know what? You're all teachers. Yeah, you're all teachers. All you artists who have posters up here. You're teaching us, you're teaching the whole city, the whole community about the dangers to our health of tobacco. And because you're our teachers, I expect that you're teaching your peers as well. You're teaching those who might want to try that first cigarette. You're teaching them it's a bad idea. It's a bad idea. It'll destroy your health. And so I want to thank you for what you've done for all of us here today. And there's going to be, you know, ninth place, eighth place, seventh place, sixth place, fifth place. There's going to be a first place winner. But I want you to know that every single one of you who's created a poster is a winner. This is one event that brings the best of Grand Rapids together all at one time and one place. It's about creativity. It's about using artistic expression to convey a message. It's about health because we know the devastating effects. Is that what we said? Devastating effects of tobacco on our health. And maybe most importantly of all, it's about youth. It's about you and what you've done and what you will do in the future for our city. So thanks for everybody for contributing. I look forward to passing out awards here today and getting a chance to meet each of you. Thanks so much.
Jose Narezo was both an artist and a teacher at Grand Rapids Public Schools. As someone who was involved with the youth of GRPS on a daily basis, he tried to share his passion for the visual arts with his students. Just one of the ways he did this was to help us create this poster contest, and so made way for his students to publicly showcase their creative talents. We're going to see a brief video right now that he made shortly before his passing in December of 2008. He will explain in his words and in a brushstrokes the creative process of painting.
I've been painting various series. The series are always motivated by family, friends, situations, everyday life, or I look at nature and I look at things around me and I try to capture the feelings, the emotion. Influenced by the masters, Tamayo, and then it was Orozco, Siqueiros, and Diego Rivera. And the more mature I felt that when I was happening in my life, my paintings were changing. I was painting relationships between couples. I was painting the relationship about the heart. And I was painting the, all those moments that one has. The idea about these, you know, it's a positive feeling about how the images appear. You know. Painting them upside down. You know how life is, you know, most of the issues you're dealing with are upside down. And when you paint them upside down and you spray, all the paint drags to the bottom. And once I took the paint off and I flipped the paintings and they look like radiation coming off the figures and going to the heavens that are above. Joy, sadness, happiness, spiritual. It's all in there.
You know, Jose always loved working with students. I remember working with him, and he said, the beauty when you're creating art, it comes from within. He goes, never tell people they have to stay within the lines or use certain colors. So for you artists out there, express yourselves. Jose used to love to work with students. All right, and now here we go. Long-awaited moment, the presentation of the awards. We have had so many very special surprises in this year because there were so many exceptional entries. The jury decided to create a new category called the Excellence Awards to recognize 10 additional posters to the 13 that were originally promised an award. So we're going to have 10 more. Recipients of these awards will receive a $25 gift card from Schuler Books and Music and a copy of Mr. DeVos's book, 10 Powerful Phrases for Positive People. It's the book that you have up here on the right. When I call your name, in no particular order, if you please come forward and stand next to your poster and stay there till I call everybody up, okay? Let's hold our applause till all the students come up. In the interest of time, you just The recipients will not have to give a speech, okay? Just come up and stand next to your poster. So here we go. If you would please come forward. Elise Adams from Northern Hills Middle School, come forward. Okay, you can clap a little bit. Come on up, Elise. Go ahead. Stand next to your poster. Abigail, I hope I say your last name right. If not, tell me how to do it. Mutisia? Okay, come tell me I did it wrong. Crestwood Middle School? Mutisia. Motasia, all right. There you go. Abigail? Where's your poster? Hold it up. Do you want him to hold it up so we can see him? Okay. There she goes. All right. Kobe Thomas from Pinewood Middle School. Kobe? Oh, there it is. Okay, Sandy, I didn't know you were holding him up. Thanks. Brady Whalen from Mona Shores Middle School. Alexa Dorsey from Mona Shores Middle School. Danny Nam from Northern Hills Middle School. Ruben Sierra from Northern Hills Middle School. Dumar Eccles Jr. from Sherwood Park Middle School. Aaron Mulder from Northern Hills Middle School. Aaron. And Robin Bauer from Northern Hills Middle School. Let's give these 10 excellent awards here to our recipients. Okay, you can have a seat. Thank you very much. And now Mr. Richard DeVos has donated his book. I don't know if you saw this. He does this every year. 10 powerful phrases for positive people for each of our first tier winners as well. These books are going to be presented by the mayor. Mayor, come back up. George Harswell, along with the other awards here. Back to work, sir. All right, for those giving awards, you have your special envelopes. I will call you up each to present your award. The fourth honorable mention award will be presented by Dale Robertson, president and CEO of the Grand Rapids Public Museum. Come on up, Dale.
Thank you. On behalf of the Grand Rapids Public Museum, I very much appreciate being here to present this award today. It's something else is also fitting. We are the oldest museum in the state of Michigan, and when Mayor Hartwell ends his term, he will be tied for the longest serving mayor in Grand Rapids history. So why don't we congratulate our mayor? So honorable mention 4 is a family membership to the Grand Rapids Public Museum, and this goes to a student in Ms. Harda's class at Northern Hills Middle School in the 7th grade, Evan Silvernail.
The title of my poster is Smoke Broke. The title has two meanings. One, obviously, is that smoking can cause financial trouble. The other, darker interpretation is that smoke broke things. Smoke broke people's lungs, people's skin, people's breath, people's brains. Smoke broke people. Let's stop it from breaking anything else.
Wow. The third honorable mention will be presented by Cindy Buckner, Associate Curator for Grand Rapids Art Museum and Poster Contest Jury Member. Cindy?
Thank you. Honorable mention three is a family membership to the Grand Rapids Public Museum, donated by the Grand Rapids Public Museum. This goes to a student in Mr. Vanderberg's class at Forest Hills Eastern in the eighth grade, Eric Silkinson.
Are you accepting on his behalf?
I will accept on his behalf.
Okay.
I do just want to say that most of the students in my class ran to the computers. They did a drawing and they brought it into Photoshop to finish it up, piece things together. And Eric ran right to the oil pastels, which nobody touched at all. And it kind of blew my mind that he would do such a thing when we got Photoshop and everything there. So I was really proud of him for doing that, taking a chance on some fine art mediums there. So it was great to see it, and I think he did a good job. So.
The second honorable mention will be presented by Margaret Vega, Professor of Fine Arts, Kendall College of Art and Design, West Michigan Artist and Poster Contest Jury Member. Margaret was one of the founding members of the Planning Committee and has served on the jury every year since the contest began. Thanks, Margaret.
It's always such a pleasure to be a part of this event, and certainly it's difficult to be on the jury because these posters are all pretty fantastic. But I'm going to be announcing the honorable mention two. It's a one-year family membership at Meyer Gardens, donated by the Frederick Meyer Gardens and Sculpture Park. And this goes to a student in Ms. Hartig's class at Northern Hills Middle in the eighth grade, Ethan Paras.
My poster brings to attention the danger of smoking. It shows children sliding down a slide that is shaped like a cigarette, but the children do not realize what's at the end of the slide. So many people do that today. They don't think about the consequence of smoking and how it will affect their health later in life. The text says it's fun until the end and suggests that even though smoking might be fun, the health problems that occur when you get older are not. The overall message I'm trying to spread by this poster is that smoking leads to serious health problems and even death. Thank you.
The first honorable mention will be presented by Dr. Jane Kortz, President of Kent Medical Foundation and President-elect Kent County Medical Society. We are proud to recognize the Kent Medical Foundation as a major sponsor of this contest for many years now. Thank you.
Thank you. On behalf of Kent Medical Foundation and Kent County Medical Society, I'm very excited to be here. And with Kent Medical Foundation, we're very pleased that we've been able to sponsor this on an ongoing basis. So thank you for that opportunity. First honorable mention, the prize is a one-year family membership at Meyer Gardens, which has been donated by Frederick Meyer Gardens and Sculpture Park. This goes to a student in Ms. Stewart's class at Pinewood Middle School in the eighth grade, Yasmin Alamela.
My poster represents a child slowly dying from his parents' or a stranger's cigarette ashes. My point on this poster was to see how easy a cigarette can harm a child. So why try to harm a child, a family member, a friend, or a stranger for a cigarette that costs $5 a pack?
Having a battle with this microphone here. Up and down. All right, here we go. And now we go to the ninth place award, which will be presented by Brenda Seip, Director, Continuing Studies, Kendall College of Art and Design.
Hello. The ninth place award is a youth art class from Kendall College of Art and Design of Ferris State University. And this goes to a student in Mrs. Klug's class at Crestwood Middle School in the eighth grade, Christina Nguyen.
My poster says cigarettes are killers that travel in packs. This is basically talking about how smoking cigarettes can lead to death. They are basically the bad guys in a gang or pack that are killing you slowly, making your lifespan shorter. If you look closely at my poster, you can see that each cigarette has a different look and personality. This represents the different ways cigarettes can kill you. For example, it can lead to pulmonary diseases like chronic bronchitis and emphysema cancer, heart disease, stroke, and among others. Also on my poster, if you look closely, one cigarette is trying to burn away the word killers. This speaks to the fact that some people don't really care that cigarettes are hurting your health. They're interested in profit. I hope my image illustrates the true nature of these seemingly innocent packs. Thank you for letting me present my poster.
The eighth place award will be presented by Walt Gutkowski Jr., First Ward City Commissioner, President and CEO, Swift Printing and Communications, and Poster Contest Jury Member. Walt has enthusiastically served this program on the Planning Committee and is a jury member for many years as well. Walt?
Are we having fun? Yeah? Isn't this great? You know, I've been doing this so long that I think Margaret was in high school when we started this. No, but I would like to take this opportunity to thank Gretchen and Dr. Tomatis, who put so much into this. So could we have a round of applause for Dr. Tomatis and his lovely wife, Gretchen? It's hard to believe after what we see, how these next eight can be better than what we saw. You guys are just so talented. You keep getting better and better each and every year. So the eighth place award is also a youth art class donated by Kendall College of Art and Design. It goes to a student, again, in Miss Clue's class at Creston Middle School. So she's obviously a very good teacher. And the winner is Camarian Harris. Congratulations.
Hi, my name is Kamarion Harris. I'm a student from Crestwood Middle School. My poster reads Domino Effect, One Cigarette Leads to Another. My poster basically tries to convince you not to start smoking because once you start, it's hard to stop. My grandma was a smoker. She was able to finally stop her addiction, but it was too late. She ended up getting cancer and dying. The dominoes on my poster represent cigarettes, and they are falling one after another, showing how addicting cigarettes can become. Finally, your health will start to tumble down just like the dominoes in my picture. Thank you for your time and considering my poster. Thank you. Thank you.
The seventh place award will be presented by Dr. John O'Donnell, Director for Preclinical Curriculum, Michigan State University College of Human Medicine.
Thank you. Most of us physicians spend a lot of time trying to talk people out of smoking. It's a hard task. I truly believe that the power that you have, you students who are doing these posters, you teachers teaching us, have a lot more power than most physicians at influencing and saving lives. All of your efforts, everything I've seen here has been really impressive and I believe effective. So, envelope is now open. Seventh place award is a digital camera donated by Meyer. And it goes once again to a student in Mrs. Klug's class at Crestwood Middle School in the eighth grade, Rosemarie Dubois.
Good afternoon. My name is Rosie Dubois. I am an eighth grade student attending Crestwood Middle School in Kentwood. A generation ago, we could use the common excuse, we were young and didn't know any better. But now we're just too bright to pretend we don't know about the harmful effects of smoking. Studies can now prove that smoking not only hurts you, but those around you. If you decide smoking today, you truly won't be the brightest grain in the box. You'll be like the ignorant cigarette hanging out of my bright box of crayons. I hope my poster encourages younger people to never start smoking. Thank you for your time.
The sixth place award will be presented by Rick Noel, Executive Director of Elementary Schools and Early Childhood Education, Grand Rapids Public Schools.
Good afternoon. On behalf of Superintendent Weatherall Neal and the entire learning community that comprises Grand Rapids Public Schools, we're very happy to see you today. One thing we tell students every day is that the best way to keep or to avoid a problem with tobacco is to never begin using tobacco. And I'm encouraged and excited about what I'm seeing here today, so keep up that good work and keep the message going. I have the privilege of the sixth place award this afternoon, and it's a digital camera donated by the Meyer Corporation, and this goes to a student in Ms. Hartig's class at Northern Hills Middle School. I need to visit Northern Hills. In the eighth grade, Carolyn Soda.
As my poster says, don't deny the reality. Smoking makes it harder for you to breathe and function the way you are meant to. I chose to put I chose to put a shrunk down pair of lungs full of cigarettes on top of a pair of big healthy lungs to represent that once you start smoking, it's harder for you to breathe. And I put the smoke on top of them looks like it's closing in, to represent that your lungs feel like they're closing in on you. I hope that smoking someday is never, people don't even know what it means. I hope that nobody new starts it. Thank you for listening to my opinion.
Very good. And now we move on to fifth place. The award will be presented by Ken Byard, Associate Principal, Mona Shores Middle School. There he comes.
Thank you. What an honor and privilege to be here. And coming from somebody that struggles to draw stick figures, I can appreciate all of your work. So artists, keep doing what you're doing. The fifth place award is a digital camera donated by Meyer, and it goes to a student in Ms. Klug's class at Crestwood Middle School in sixth grade, Dana Eck.
My name is Dana Ekich, and I'm a sixth grader from Crestwood Middle School. My poster reads, "You wouldn't drink poison, why smoke it?" The reason I did this slogan is because we know Now, there are a lot of chemicals in cigarettes. For example, you find some of the same chemicals in hair dye and nail polish remover. If someone asked you to drink nail polish remover, you wouldn't, so why smoke it? I hope my poster gets some people to think about the harmful substances they are putting into their body when they smoke. I wish my grandpa had known all this since he died from cancer when I was then 10. Thank you for supporting, sharing my poster.
And now the fourth place award will be presented by Michael Zorhoff, Superintendent, Kentwood Public Schools.
Thank you. What an honor it is to be here in front of all these incredible artists. You're amazing. I sit and I marvel at that. Thank you to all our educators out there too, and our parents for encouraging your kids. And thank you, kids, for having the courage to step out and try something new and really put together something with a positive message and to fight this awful thing that we're fighting today. So, without further ado, our fourth place award is a digital camera donated by Meyer. This goes to a student in Mrs. Klug's class at Crestwood Middle School in the eighth grade. Good job, Mrs. Klug, by the way. Ian Rea.
Developed in China and introduced to the U.S. in 2007, smokeless e-cigarettes were thought to be better for you. But that's up for debate. Hello, my name is Ian Ray, and I come from Crestwood Middle School. I would like to take this opportunity to present my poster, which reads, "E-cigarettes are not the new technology." Since the invention of the smokeless e-cigarette, the total world market sales have grown to nearly $3 billion. Money motives, and perhaps that is why so many insist this new cigarette is an alternate and traditional way to smoking. This vaporous chemical mix may not contain tobacco, but a whopping 7,000 chemicals are inside this device. Why be a guinea pig for an industry known to sacrifice its customers for profit? This technology is not advancing society, but creating a new generation of nicotine addicts. In conclusion to this presentation, I must say that e-cigarettes are not the new technology. Just buy an iPad instead.
Wow. The third place award will be presented by Daniel Beam, Superintendent, Forest Hills Public Schools.
Thank you, Eva. Well, I think we can all agree, looking at these posters, but more importantly, hearing from the artists we've heard from already, that we are well on our way to crushing tobacco. Some great artists and great leaders. I want to say a word of thanks to Dr. Tomatis for his passion and personal perseverance in this battle that has taken way too many lives from so many of our families and loved ones. I want to thank the RDV Corporation for their continued support of this program. I want to thank the Graham and Dana and all the work that you do here, the jury members for their time. And I would like to thank really our teachers who inspire these incredible gifts in our students for all that you do. We would not be the world that we certainly will become because of all of your work, teachers, and certainly our families for all the support that you give to education. Most importantly to our students, I hope what you can see is that art is an incredibly powerful medium to transfer and transmit any message out to society, and this is such an important one. And as the great artist Pablo Picasso said himself, the meaning of life is to find your gift. And the purpose of life is to give your gift away. And I think we see many examples of that right in front of us right here. So without further ado, I have the honor to present the third place award for best presentation. And it is an iPad donated by Steelcase, an iPod donated by Steelcase. This goes to a student in Mrs. Klug's class at Crestwood Middle School in the sixth grade, Jad Ramadan. Jad. Jad, congratulations.
About a year ago, I encouraged my dad to stop smoking, and I am happy to say he is now a non-smoker after 30 plus years of smoking. I am very proud of him. So, I was excited to have this opportunity to help more people stop smoking. Hello, my name is Jad Ramadan, and I'm a sixth grader at Crestwood Middle School. My poster is about e-cigarettes. I noticed recently several news reports on how the makers of these products target youths. A couple of weeks ago, I was watching Channel 8 News and saw a story where two girls went undercover who were minors, 14 and 15 years old, and were able to buy e-cigarettes at a store selling them. That gave me the idea to create this poster. Mrs. Klug then encouraged me to read some recent reports from the New York Times and Wall Street Journal about this controversy. I learned that the makers of e-cigs go to special events where teens like to go, like music festivals, parties, and motorsports events, and give away free sample. They also use flavors that appeal to kids, like Starburst, Jolly Ranchers, and Smarties. Studies also show that liquid nicotine can hurt developing teen brains like mine. My poster shows a dartboard, and the darts are e-cigarettes being propelled toward the target. My message reads, e-cigarettes. My message reads, e-cigs targeting teens. The target in my picture represents teenagers everywhere. I want to tell kids out there not to smoke and don't think you're cool when you smoke, even the new e-cigarettes. Thank you for hearing my message today.
Good job. I like where you get your news. Okay, gone to the second place award, which will be presented by Brian Cloyd, VP for Global Corporation Relations at Steelcase.
Wow, I'm really impressed. I can't believe how talented these students are, how insightful, and how intellectual they are. I've learned so much in the last 15 minutes than I have in a long time about how cigarettes can ruin your health, and I appreciate all of the work that you've put into this. So, the second place award for best art is an iPod from Steelcase, and it goes to a student from guess whose class? Mrs. Klug's class at Crestwood Middle School. And the winner is Savannah Posey.
My poster explains you don't have to be smart to say no to smoking. Rocket science isn't hard. It takes a lot of work and schooling to enter this career. But the decision not to smoke is not rocket science. You don't need a lot of brains to know that smoking is bad for you or harmful. Smoking is easy, but hard to quit. The rocket in my picture is actually a cigarette going into flames, just like your life will go up into flames if you decide to start smoking. Thank you.
And the Jose Narezo First Prize Award. I gave you your envelope.
Yes, you did.
Okay, that's all right. We're just having a moment here. That's okay. The Jose Narezo First Prize Award will be presented by the mayor. George Hartwell. There you go.
Who is this guy? Okay, we've got the first place award, the Jose Narezo
First place award for best overall poster. It's an iPad donated by the Richard and Helen DeVos Foundation. We have it right here along with the book. This goes to students in Mr. Vandenberg's class at Forest Hills Eastern in the eighth grade. It's shared by two students. Let's have a drum roll. All right. Sam Volk and Drew Kunick.
All right, my poster is supposed to represent, and Sam's poster, that cigarettes are just like fish hooks because you could get addicted to cigarettes just like a fish could get hooked on a fish hook, and the fish will get eaten by the fisherman, and you will get eaten by all the toxic chemicals in the cigarette, and thank you.
Wow. I just have to ask, is Mrs. Clue here in the audience? Raise your hand. Where are you? Yay, let's give her a round of applause for all the students in her classroom. You're doing something right there. At this time, we would appreciate if all the winners would please come to the stage and stand beside your poster for picture time with the mayor. So we have you come up here. And again, thank you for congratulations to all the winners of this year's Nicotine Poster Contest 2015. Let's give a round of applause. The reception follows afterwards right outside. Thank you. Do I have more to say?
All right, all you photographers, come on up. Come on up. Let's start over here, shall we? You got somebody taking a picture?
Oh, I hit the gentleman.
There we go. This is cool.
You gotta take everything.
All right. There we go. Congratulations. Whoops. What's that? I'm writing stuff on a poster. All right. There we go.